Good morning, dear students. This is Sachin Khanna. I hope you are well. Today we will start with our new subject, that is macroeconomics for class plus two. Now let us first understand कि अभी तक हम क्या पढ़ते हैं. We have already studied in microeconomics. That is what we see is that microeconomics deals with what individuals. Now what does this individuals means? Individual means individual persons, individual firms, individual industry or individual market. All these will be studied under microeconomics. That is, if I talk of you or me, then the economic problem would be studied under microeconomics. If I talk of a particular factory, then it will be studied under microeconomics. If I talk of a particular industry, that is plywood industry in India, that would also be studied under microeconomics. If I talk of a particular market, example, perfect market, that is we see perfect competition, oligopoly, duopoly, oligopolistic or monopolistic, that all will be studied under microeconomics. Now let us understand what we do under macroeconomics. The word macro has come from Greek word macros, and this macros means large. Under macroeconomics, we would be dealing with the aggregates, which means we will study economy as a whole. So not a particular person, not a particular firm, not a particular industry or not a particular market. When we study the complete economy or economy as a whole, it means all the goods and services produced in all the markets or industries of a country, that would be studied under macroeconomics. Getting my point? So micro में हम individuals की बात कर रहे हैं और macro में हम aggregates की बात कर रहे हैं. So now here the question comes that you can note it down. Microeconomics does not deal with aggregates. Microeconomics does not deal with aggregate. You have to comment. The answer would be false, because in aggregates, in macroeconomics, we mean economy as a whole. But when I talk of a particular industry, it means private industry in India, which may contain around 10,000 factories. So, sab ki sab will be studied under microeconomics, right? So, aggregates at small level. Aggregates at small level. You have to note this down yourself. Handwritten notes will help you a lot for your preparation. Getting my point? Now let us understand that why and how does macroeconomics was required, or what are the two main characteristics of macroeconomics. So aaiye pehle samjhte hain. We will study about two major economists or contributors to economics. The very first is Adam Smith, and the other is Lord John Maynard Keynes, right? We also call him as J.M. Keynes, right? Now Adam Smith was of the thought, इन्होंने क्या एक नई थ्योरी दी मार्केट में through his book, which was published in 1776, that is An Inquiry into the nature and cause of wealth of nations. He said that an economy which is resource rich may or may not be a rich economy or a developed economy. Rather, an economy who has a good production process, which has the capability of converting the raw material or the resources into finished goods and sell them, will be a rich economy or a developed economy. So that is if we talk of South Africa, this is one of the most resource-rich countries in the world. But the country is not rich. It means resources to sabse zyada hai. For example, we say diamonds. Lekin wo country jo hai wo developed nation nahi hai. Right? So, for being a developed nation, you need to have the good manufacturing process or the production process. Also, Adam Smith said that an economy will always operate at full employment equilibrium. Always operate at full employment equilibrium. Right? That is, there is no need of government intervention. There is no need of government intervention. But Lord John Maynard Keynes, what he observed during the Great Depression of 1929, tab se lekar aage tak, inhone jo book launch kari wo kya thi, aur fir dekhte hain what was his theory. The book was Economic Consequences of Peace. The other book was General Theory of Employment, Interest and Money. So, इन्होंने ऑब्जर्व किया कि इस ग्रेट डिप्रेशन के बाद इन यूएस देयर वॉज 25% इंक्रीज इन अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट रेट विच वॉज टू ह्यूज गेटिंग अ पॉइंट. Then he observed that that Adam Smith said that there is no need of government intervention, but he said that we need to study an economy in its entirety. It means economy as a whole. Economy as a whole, and a country will not compulsorily operate at full employment level or full employment equilibrium. Rather, there can be three conditions of equilibrium. The very first was, that is, under employment equilibrium. Second was full employment equilibrium. And third was over full employment equilibrium. Getting my point? So we say that the founding father of macroeconomics was Adam Smith. But after the theory of Lord J.M. Keynes, the subject matter of macroeconomics was born. It was around in 1930s. Around in 1930s. Now you need to understand that all these three types of equilibrium we will be going to study in our later chapters. Thank you and have a nice day.